The mechanical engineers, the amount of scope mechanical engineers has, I feel no other engineers have. Okay. Even computer science doesn't have it. Computer science will get a job when only till he does programming well. Okay, afterwards, the mindset, the mental abilities will grow lesser with the time. So that will affect his career option improvement. Okay. Whereas mechanical engineers is continuous improvement. Now the slope you have to see what you will decide. Okay, the more when you get the higher degrees, the slope is higher, especially M.Tech degrees. PhD also helps, but PhD is sometimes risky also because you do not know whether you'll complete it or not, correct? Nowadays it is not like that. Nowadays it is getting completed. Okay, nobody says that if you are not good enough, if the professor feels you are not good enough, he will put you out within 6 months. First of all, you will not get selected. First of all, if you get selected also, and if it is a wrong selection, then within 6 months you are out.
So 35.57.
How much?
35.57.
Wrong, wrong. It is 44.18 degree. See where you have done mistake. Yesterday, Shane was doing some problem on thermodynamics and he was not getting it right. Okay. Now, had I given the answer to him, okay, he wouldn't have improved. He wouldn't have got the skills to see where the problem is. So initially, when you don't get the answer, you have to struggle with the answer. Okay. But let me by then. Yeah, others. Answer is 44.18 degrees. Okay. The other students, you can solve those Shom series problem which I've given yesterday. Okay. Keep on solving. Okay, can you do it, students? 44 did you get? So let us see what is GA. GA comes as G into A, correct? G to A. What should I go? I should go minus, say G into A. I have to go minus 300 along Y, correct? Or yes, or we have to go along X. What should I go? I should go X minus 400, correct? So it is minus 400 I. Minus 300 G, correct? And then what is K? Plus 500 K. What is GB? GB is given as 100 I, correct? Then minus 300 J plus 500 K. Easy, students. So what you do? You just find out cos inverse of minus 400 I, okay? Or you can say 400 We'll put it directly here. 400 into 100, 4000. 4000 plus. So minus is there, minus 4000. Okay, then plus, because these two are multiplying, 300 into 300. What is 300 into 300? 900. 900 plus 500 into 500. How much is that? 500 into 500 is 25,000, correct? This is 9,000, I'm sorry. This is 9,000. 4,000, yeah, this is 4,000 plus 9,000 into 25,000, correct? 500 into 500 is 25,000, is it not, students? Correct? Okay. Yeah, that is 25,000 or correct, no? 500, 500 is 2,50,000, correct, students? Am I wrong? 2,50,000, correct? 500 into 500, you see? Correct. Okay. 300 into 300 is 90,000, not 9,000.
90,000 and 40,000.
40,000, yes. So add that down and then GA magnitude. You can take the GA magnitude here.
Sir.
Yeah. What is answer?
Sir, in the GA vector, how is it minus 300, sir?
GA vector. Oh, I'm sorry.
Yeah, it is plus
300. Correct. I'm sorry. It is plus 300, not minus 300. It's plus 300.
Okay.
Correct. Okay. So 100 square plus 300 square plus 500 square. One step answer. Okay. Into square root of 100 square plus 300 square plus 500 square. This is 400 square. Do it, students, and get the answer. Simple and straight. What is the passing was? One step answer.
Sir, I got 49.09.
No, wrong again.
44, sir.
44.18. See, one of the main thing in VTU, what our professors have done is, they are solving problems in the class only. They want you to score high ranks in high marks in VTU exam. So they have made you to solve. They have solved every problems in the class. That is a major mistake in VTU we do. We don't allow students to develop. It is like giving them fish rather than teaching them fishing. Okay, so you have to improve that first, students. You have to get it by yourself. Others, Sagar, have you got the answer?
Yes, sir, yes.
Okay. Grishma, yes, you will get it, obviously. Okay. Grishma, Megha. Varsha?
Thank you, sir.
Okay, first. That first level where you try by your own and you get the answer, if you have not gone through that, then you cannot achieve something higher. The first thing is that try these kind of things, very important. Okay, by yourself, simple one only, not very great. Okay, we cannot talk about great things if we cannot do the simple one. Jagali haradavanu gagana hariyane.
Got it, sir. 44.81.
Very good. Patience. Now, when you go with complex problems, one of the main thing you should have is patience. Okay. You should not rush into the answers. If you rush into the answers, you will go wrong. Okay. Initially, don't rush into the answer. Think. And speed comes naturally. You don't have to worry about speed. Okay. Just like somebody who is, doing embroidery, for example. Okay. A lady who is doing embroidery. Okay. Because ladies are generally doing embroidery. That doesn't mean that men don't do it. But you see, they do it very fast, correct? A person starting initially, he cannot do it fast. And if he thinks he will run like that, the needle will, prick him, is it not? So it's very important that initially we go slow and speed comes naturally as you do more and more practice, okay? That is one thing we have to keep in mind, okay? Don't rush, okay? See, there is a great thing, some American music band, they have given one, song, Don't Rush. Okay, you can see that sometimes.
Sir, what is the ratio like in Invernal?
What is that?
I just want to know the ratio what we are getting, cos, sir. Because I am getting 29. Don't know where is it.
Yeah. So what they got is cos inverse of 0.717.
Okay, sir.
0.717. See whether you get that. You have to get it,
sir.
Yes.
So can you tell me how we are assigning signs for GA and GB vectors, sir?
Okay. See, what we have to see is from this point, which direction we are going, which is the direction, which is positive direction. This is positive direction. This is positive direction, correct? So the positive directions are x positive is in this direction, y is in this direction, z is in up direction. Okay. So now from G to A, if I have to go, how will I go? I have to go in the negative x direction by 400, correct? This is positive x. I'm going negative x by 400, correct? So that is why negative 400. Makes sense?
Yes, correct? Yes.
Now in the y direction. Now here in the y direction I'm going. From here, I have to go in the y direction. In the y direction, how much should I go? 300. 300 is that. Along z direction, how much should I go? 500. I reach it. So I go 400i plus 300j plus 500k. I will reach point A.
Got how it, sir. Thank you.
How do you say a person walking from one place to other? You say walk so much of steps, then take right so many steps, then take left so many steps, you will go, right? So that I, J, K are directions. 400 is like steps. Make sense?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
So you may say, sir, then what? Can't I go first like this? Yes, you can go. You can say 300J first. Then you go minus 400i next, then plus 500j next. You can do that. Or you can go first 500 up like this, then 300 like this, then 400 like this, then 300 this way. Anyway, you can go. Okay, you can interchange this thing. Okay, it doesn't matter. Okay, makes sense. Okay. Next question.
So I got answer. There was a mistake with application.
Ah.
Calculation. Calculator application was wrong, sir. So I used gate calculator. I got correct answer.
Whenever you go with what is it, gate, 90% of the mistakes happens in calculations. So calculation mistake is the first thing you have to go. And most of the students rush into the answers. That's why they do mistakes, because of pressures. Okay, pressure is the main reason why people do mistakes. Don't get into pressure. Be cool. Okay.
Sir, actually, I got correct ratio, but don't know. There was mistake with app, I guess. So I got wrong answer.
Probably. Okay. You have not understood that calculator. That's it.
Sir, yesterday you had said something like AB unit vector is equal to L square plus M square plus N square is equal to, it should come 1.
Yes.
Here if we do, will it come 1 like that GA unit vector?
Yes. You find GA unit vector and tell me.
It comes like minus 0.56i plus 0.42j. Plus 0.707k.
Plus 0.707k. Do that. 0.56 square plus 0.42 square plus 0.707 square. Would you not get one? See?
0.98. Yeah. We're getting. Yep.
So that is there.
So that is a check we can do if we are.
If we are right or wrong.
Right or wrong, yeah.
Correct.
Sure, sir, sure.
Okay. This is how you have to go. Slow and steady, no rush. Okay. Only like this, if you do, you will clear gate. Okay. If you rush into things and think gate is something big, it is not so. It's a fundamental exam. It is not a difficult exam. It is not, something very, very difficult. It's very easy, elementary. Okay. Fine. So let us understand this. Okay. Express a force, very simple. Okay, you may ask me, sir, why are you giving this? Okay, express a force, but this is as a practice. Okay. Express a force in terms of unit vectors I, J, K. J, K, express the force in terms of I, J, K. Whose magnitude magnitude is 200 Newton, 200 Newton, that starts at a point that is applied at a point, that is applied at a point 2, 5, -3 and points to the direction of -3, 2, 1. So what is there? There is a point 2, 5, -3, 2, 5, -3, and it points to the direction of -3, in the sense z is the same. X is here. It points to the direction of -3, which is in the x direction. 2 is somewhere here, and 1. Okay, so it points in this direction. Okay, can you find the force vector? Simple and straight. So this is point A, this is point B, which is given by -3, 2, 1. Can you find the force vector? Why this is done is to make you understand how the things move. What should I do first? First, I should see magnitude is there. The force vector, what you have here is nothing but magnitude of force vector into the direction of force vector. What is important to find out the unit vector here? What is the unit vector from A to B we have to find? So if I say unit vector AB, okay, or vector AB, if I say vector AB, we will put in terms of displacement vector. If you say displacement vector A to B, it is always B position vector B minus position vector A, very important, with respect to a coordinate system, okay, with respect to 0, 0, 0 somewhere, okay. So let us do that. Somewhere here, 0, 0, 0 is there, somewhere here, okay, somewhere here. I don't know where it is, okay, you can see that, okay. So now AB can be written as PB, which is that minus 3i plus 2j plus k minus here plus 5j minus 3k, correct. Now this gives us unit vector, so you will get -5i, correct, plus -3j -2k. This is the vector, correct, students? See, it is in the third coordinates. So what is happening? All are minus, okay, all minus, you know. So that is important here. That to show direction, okay. So what is AB unit vector? AB unit vector is -5i, -3j, -2k, divided by square root of 5² + 3² + 2². Find the unit vector, students. And then that unit vector, you can put it here. So force vector is equal to 200 into AB unit vector. That's it. Tell me what is that. Fast.
Sir, that is
negative. Sir, it should be 4K.
4K, sir.
Plus minus
3K.
Plus 4K. See, rushing. Even if you know the things, if you rush into the things, you're gone. 4².
So that AB vector can be also written as position of vector A minus position of vector B?
No, it cannot be written. Always you have to keep in mind delta. When you say delta y, it is y2 minus y1.
Okay.
Ending minus starting.
Yeah, sure.
Final result minus initial result. That is a change. we lag to get high ranks in gate because our basics are not strong, simple and straight. Okay, we can do well. It's like, just like, have you seen this Karate Kid movie? If you see, you see that like that Jackie Chan trains that young kid. He asks him to just tie the coat, okay, the coat which is there, put it here. Then he starts with kung fu. Okay? So basics, when you are strong, only then you will be strong somewhere. Okay. It all comes by practice and Shraddha. Shraddha is very important. Shraddha is there here? No. There was one Shraddha. I think she did not come. Shraddha is there? No. Okay. Shraddha Shetty was there. Okay. Don't worry. Shraddha is not there. Okay. So we have to get Shraddha now. I will call her today. Then somebody else are there. Riyaz has not come yet. Okay. Then who else is there? Whom I can take the names properly. Okay. Siddhi Vinayaka is there. Okay. We need him always. Okay. Then students, have you got it? 141. The old students, just keep patience. Okay. 84.9J. In between, you will get some insights. Okay. Grishma Megha, got this answer?
Yes, sir.
Very good.
Yes, sir.
Charan?
Yes, sir. Got it, sir.
Very good. Okay. Next question. Okay. Try it out. Okay. Let me put it on the... Okay. We don't have to. Now this another next question has come in gate actually. Okay. Similar question, not the same question. Similar question has come in gate. Okay, let us do that. Okay. Once we finish that. We're not in any rush. Not done, students? Who has not got the answer? Deepesh got the answer?
Yeah, I got it. Sorry, didn't inform that. Yeah, I got it.
Okay. Vishal Shetty? Who did not get the answer? Vishal got it?
Yes, sir, got it.
Okay, so everybody has got it. Then why are you not? Shane?
Yes, sir. Got
Shane? Oh, then you should tell me, yaar. I am just spending time. Okay. Fine. Is there anybody who has not got the answer? No. Okay. Now, let us understand the next. What this has come in gate, similar problem has come in gate. Okay. What horizontal force is required to hold the 10 newton weight, 10 newton weight, 10 newton weight W in the position in the position shown in the figure. Position shown in the figure. Let us see that. So the force is like this. This is in this fashion. Then there is a force applied here, a horizontal force, okay? Horizontal force, which is P, okay? Then here you have a weight W, which is equal to 10 Newton. Okay, W, that equals 10 Newton, okay? There's a weight here. Okay, so it is pulled here. Okay, this angle is 72 degrees. This has come in gate. What is required is find out, not centigrade, okay, find out P. What horizontal force is required to hold the 10 Newton weight in the position shown in the figure? What you do, students, you put Lamy's theorem directly and get the answer, simple and straight. So if this is 72, you have to find out what is this angle. I hope you can do that, students. Find it out. So one is at P here. These are all unsolved problems. If this is 72 degree, then you have a force here, tension here, and then the weight here. Only thing you have to do is P by sine this angle, say alpha, is equal to W by say beta. Sine beta, sine alpha. Only thing here is to find out alpha and beta. That's it. Direct Lamy's theorem, you get the answer. These kind of questions, if it comes, it's lollipops. Correct. So what is this angle, students? This is 72, then this is 90. So this is 18, 18 plus 90, is it not? Is it not 18 plus 90, 108 degrees. So it is P by, if it is 108 degree, then the other one is, what is beta? Beta is 108. Correct, students, beta is 108, correct, no? Unsolved problem, so I may do mistakes. Tell me if I've done, this is gamma, okay? So what is alpha? Alpha is 360. Minus 108 minus 90, correct? So what is that answer, you tell me, and that you apply here. Tell us fast, student, don't wait for others. Does P comes to 3.25 newtons? Just see that.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Right, okay. So you have got the answer. We will go for the next one, okay? This comes a lot of times in our this one. So let us understand this, okay? So there is a 15. Yes, sir. This is very much. Very simple ones, okay, but very important ones.
Yes, sir.
Very good, okay. Next point, okay. Next point here is this, okay. See, there is one cube, okay. There is a cube. Or there is a thing like this, okay. With, say, not to scale, students, not to scale. So this is 2 meters. This is 3 meters. And this is 4 meters. Okay. There is a force which is in this direction. Diagonal, from this diagonal to this diagonal, there is a force which is acting P. Okay. And magnitude of P is equal to 50 Newton. Find P. Find a P vector. Can you do that, students? I'm sorry. Find P vector. Fast, do it, students. We are not worried about all the things. Speed is key here. old students also can do it, because the new students are also now well versed with these things. Very sorry, students. It's bad. Cold for me. See whether you get PRs. Tell me. Talk slowly and talk fully. Because sometimes we switch on the mic and we start talking before switching on the mic. And just before we finish talking, we switch off the mic. So here I don't get anything. Did you get this answer? Who had that question?
Sir, P is acting along the diagonal or in the...
Along the diagonal.
Okay.
Along the diagonal. Now this I, J may change, depends on what you take as the X, Y, Z. You can take any X, Y, Z. Okay. This was taken with respect to this as X, this as Y, and this is Z. You could have chosen something else also. No problem. So you will get this interchange. That's it. Next, we will see the angles, very important. This is one important ones which we miss a lot of times, okay? The inclined plane problems comes a lot of times in viscosity, in friction and all those things. We miss a lot of times how to solve it. Okay, let us see that.
We should find here.
Find P. P is not given. Find P. This is the answer. I'm sorry. This is the answer. Okay. So the answer is P is equal to what was it I wrote? Answer was 37.2 I. What were you doing till now, Mr. Nahinji?
No, sir. I was
okay.
I got different answers though.
What is the answer you got? Did you get this interchange? Then it's okay. If you get something like 27.9i plus 37.2j plus 18.6k, fine, no problem with that. Take XYZ like this only so that there's no confusion. How many of you have not got this? Please tell me. How many of you have not got this answer?
Doing, sir.
Doing. Okay, very good.
Got, sir.
Oh, very good. The people who have got it, I'll give you another question, which gives the another question. This is one question. This is another question. The question is like that. Okay. The rectangular component of a force F in the direction is F is 10 Newton in the direction OH, direction OH. In direction OH, okay. If the force F if the force F acts in the xy plane, in the xy plane, with xy plane making an angle, making an angle of 60 degree to the x-axis, determine the force vector. Determine the force vector. The OH direction is making an angle of 45 degrees to the x-axis. OH direction makes an angle of 45 degree with the x-axis. So what is happening here? You have, say this is x, this is y, okay? Along OH direction, this is OH direction. Along OH direction, which is at 45 degree, the component of this force is 10 Newton. So 10 Newton component of this force is 10 Newton. That means this is 90 degree. Find out the force F. That is the question. So component need not be in X and Y only. It can be with respect to any other things also. Then one more point I have to say in terms of components only. And this is a common question that comes in GATE. Component does not mean it is only along X and Y. Then inclined plane problem, both we will do. This was changed according by me. Okay, the first question, did you get this P question? Did you get, students? Everybody who
sir,
did not get
this, yes, question? Sir,
got it. Very good. Okay. So write this down. Next, I'll go for the next slide. So this everybody has got, I suppose. So like this, one step by step when you do. You will not know the difficulty of GATE only. Step by step, you go on doing. GATE will be easy, okay? But you have to spend so much of time, that's it. And you are very intelligent students. I compare the students who get into PSU, some of them, okay? And compare your intelligence. No way less. IIT, when I went to IIT, the M-Techs who were there, who were coming along with me, who had much higher rank than me, okay, are much less intelligent than my students. Intelligence is separate, perseverance is separate, keep in mind. What they have is perseverance. And some of them will not have good English also. They will be good in engineering. There was one friend of mine, okay, in the sense he was doing his MS in IIT Madras, okay. He was a son of a coolie worker, okay. And this guy went to a campus interview in Renault-Nissan. Okay, Renault-Nissan campus interview happened after his MS in refrigeration air conditioning department, okay. And he's going to Renault-Nissan and saying, sir, I have cleared written test and everything, but my English is not that good, he said. I'm very poor in English, he said, because obviously he's from Tamil medium, so English is very poor. The person sitting in front of him was a Frenchman. He said, my English not good, in his French accent. So it is not important to have good English. English is just a language, keep in mind. And he got selected into that Renault-Nissan company, around 11 lakh per annum salary he was getting. In Chennai, that's a great thing. He wanted localites also to manage their production. Done, students. Let us go. Have you written this down? That's enough. So what is important here is, let us go a bit fast.
Rectangular component.
Yeah, rectangular component. A force F is 10 Newton in the direction of OH.
Sir, like what is a rectangular component?
I'll tell you. I'll tell you what is rectangular component.
Why? Sir, what is the answer, sir?
For which one?
This one, rectangular component.
I don't know. Okay. What is the answer you have got? Because I made it now.
10.35.
Huh?
10.35.
What is that? That is the magnitude. That is correct.
A magnitude.
Magnitude F, correct. Very good. Okay. Tell me the vector.
Y.17i 8.96j.
Very good. Simple. So F is nothing but you can write 10.35 cos 60 plus 10.35 sin 60. Correct, student. That's cos 60i sin 60j. Simple. Very simple ones we are doing. Okay. Now let us understand what is a rectangular component. Okay. So when you say rectangular component, suppose you have a force here, F. I need rectangular components in this direction. You say H, in the H direction. What I do? I drop a perpendicular here. When I drop a perpendicular here, I can drop another perpendicular here. Okay, I can draw a parallel here. Observe. I can draw another parallel over here. And now this becomes a rectangle. So you have one component here, one component here, sorry, one component over here, sorry, one component here, another component here, rectangular components. Makes sense? Not just here, I have to go till here, I'm sorry. Go till the origin. Okay, so you have a rectangular components, one component here, one component here. Makes sense? Okay, that's why it's called rectangular component. It is rectangle. Rectangle is inclined, obviously. Okay, here. Next problem. Okay, it is like this, student. This is one question which everybody has a problem. Okay, most of them initially. Okay, in VTU, this is a problem, not in other places. Okay, so you have an inclined plane. And most of them, we will do mistakes in this only. There is an inclined plane. Okay, on this inclined plane, there is a force. This has a weight of, say W. Okay, what is the component of weight in this direction? What is the component of weight in this direction? The angle is, say, theta. Okay, what is it over here? Simple and straight. What is the component of force in this direction?
W sine theta.
Good. W sin theta. I hope everybody got this. Very simple one. Okay. This one thing people do mistakes. Okay. Let us take another one, similar one. Okay. Let us have an angle a bit differently, we will put. Okay. Very, very simple one. Today we are doing all simple things, sir, students. Okay. I have a block here. Okay. And this block is pulled up by 235 newtons. This block is pulled up by 235 newtons, okay, which is acting at an angle of, say, this is a 22 degree, this is a 22 degree, and this is acting at an angle of, say, I can say this angle is 60 degree. This angle is 60 degree. This angle is 60 degree. Calculate the components of this force in this direction as well as this direction. Components of force in the, say, tangential direction and normal direction. Say, T direction and N direction. Find the components. Simple and straight. This is 22 degrees. This is at an angle of 60 degree with the horizontal, very important. 60 degree with the horizontal. You have to struggle a bit, I do know. How do you solve this? You solve this by first taking a point here, okay? I'll not spend time here, but I will just tell you how to do it, okay? So you take a point here, okay? And this angle is 60 degrees. this angle comes as 60 degree. Right. Now this whole thing, what you're doing is, this particular one, if you see, first initially it was like this. Then what happens, you tilt it by 22 degrees. So when you tilt that from here, this is what, say this is X and Y from here, say X and Y. Okay, then you keep this point over here. Okay, that's how you have to get the tangent. Okay, so what you do, this is X and Y. Okay, if you consider our T and N will be here, right? T and N is at an angle of 22 degrees, correct? So what is this? This is 38 degrees. Make sense? This is T, this is N. Make sense? This is X and Y. Let me put it as X and Y. Correct? TN is in this direction. Make sense, students? So 38 degrees. So how do you find out? You find out, this is very simple, but sometimes you miss. So what happens? 235. So the answer is along T, it is 235 cos 38. Along N, the component is 235 sine 38. Make sense? Don't make mistakes in these things, students. It's all simple ones, but still, okay? We have to do first simple ones, is it not? I've told you. Simple things has to be done first. These kind of questions appears a lot in GATE, and we have to be clear in that, finding the components at least. Step by step, everything is important, okay? Next, we will go with a cross product, okay? 10 minutes we have, you write this down neatly. This we have done, students. I'm saying it's for, even for VTU, it's easy, is it not? But we do mistakes, let me tell you, in this only, taking components only, we do mistakes. Tell me when you're finished writing, students. Done writing?
Yes, sir.
Very good. Next. Next one, we'll go with cross product. Very simple one. Cross product. Okay. Now, if I have A vector as equal to AXI plus AYJ plus AZK, and B vector is equal to BXI plus BYJ plus BZK, then A crossed with B, A crossed with B is actually equal to IJK into AX, AY, AZ, then BX, BY, BZ. Very important. This would be the direction of the cross product. Simple. This would be the cross product. So you will get some number. You will find this as AY, BZ minus AZ, BY into I minus, we will have AX, BZ minus AZ, BY into J plus AX, BY minus BX, AY into K. This is very important in fluid mechanics, in strength of materials. Okay, whenever we take moments, we will see moments in a by today or tomorrow, we will see moments, students. Okay, so when we take moments, this cross product is very, very important. Okay.
So in the second statement, AZ into BX, right?
Correct. AZ into, no, BY, BY, correct. Okay, this is correct. Here.
Second one.
Yes, yes, BX. I'm very sorry. My bad, students. Okay. The third one is right, is it not? Okay, fine, good. Don't write it just like that, okay? Think and write. And don't by heart, okay? Yeah, you might have seen that our three idiots, how that person Chatur Ramalingam does it, is it not? So don't do that. Balatkar ho jayega. So well done, is it not? I enjoyed that movie like anything. Done, students? Now, another point here. One more point we have to get is this. Okay. See, if I have vector A here, vector B over here, and then we have it an angle of alpha, then what is the direction of A cross B? A cross B, when you see, what we have to do is we have to go with A crossed with B like this. We have to say the direction A crossed with B. Now, or we will put this as A cross B is like this. Okay. Let me put this as A, this is B. Very important. This is the most important thing. I'll write it big. Okay. So that you'll understand the importance, because when I write small, you think it is very small, this one concept. Okay. So I will write this as A, this is B. Very, very important concept, students. Okay. So I'm doing A crossed with B, and say this angle is alpha. Okay. Then this one will be perpendicular. Is that A crossed with B will be perpendicular to both B, perpendicular to both B and A. Very important. It will be perpendicular to A as well as B. Okay, so it's a three-dimensional image. Keep in mind. So it should be perpendicular to both A as well as B. Important. And keep in mind, this is this direction. Okay, this direction is B crossed with A. Now, how do you fix this direction? Very important. How is that we fix this direction? We fix this direction by using right hand thumb rule. A crossed with B. See the direction. A crossed with B. Direction is along the thumb. Right hand rule. Make sense? Make sense, students? Or you could also say like this. This is A. This is B. This is the first vector to be done. Second vector, third vector direction is along the middle finger. Make sense? Does it make sense, students? And we have to keep in mind, A cross B is equal to minus of B cross A. So, cross product is not commutative. A cross product is not commutative, very important. Another point we have to understand is when you say A cross B, sorry, A cross B, magnitude of that is equal to magnitude of A into magnitude of B into sine alpha. Very important. So when the angle between these two goes to zero, this reduces, the size reduces. If this is alpha is equal to 90 degree, the size of this particular line will be very big. Just think, as you go like this, it becomes bigger and bigger. Have that particular animation going in your mind. When it is going bigger and bigger, it becomes biggest when it is 90 degree. Then again, it goes higher than 90 degree, it will reduce. Okay, so like that. Okay, that has to be understood. Okay, so it depends on sign. Okay. just run that imagination in your mind. Change the angle, you know, animation, you can animate in your mind, is it not? So very, very important thing here, students, write this. Now, what is the importance of that? Let us see. Okay. Students, area, is it a scalar or a vector? Area is a vector, not a scalar, very important. It has direction. Okay. So if you want to find the area of a parallelogram, cross product is one which you have to go. Okay. Have you written this down, students, till here? Tell me when you're finished. Tell me when you're finished writing, students. Then we will go area of a area vector. Let us see how do we find the area vector. Similar way, we can find the area of a triangle. Okay. These are very important basic concepts.
Done, sir.
Done, very okay.
Done, sir.
So now, if you say area, this is a simple one. Old students might feel it very simple, but still, okay. If I say, for example, a parallelogram, okay, people may give the coordinates also, okay. So if you have A, B, C, D, okay, the area of this parallelogram is nothing but area A, B, C, D. Is actually equal to AB position vector multiplied by AD position vector. This is the area vector. Which direction it is?
Cross product.
Huh?
Cross product.
Cross product, yes. Okay. It is cross product. Area is nothing but AB crossed with AD. And when you say AB crossed with AD, you get the area of this. If you have to say the triangle, then what is a triangle? ABD. If you want to find the triangle ABD, area of triangle ABD, then it is half into AB crossed with AD. Correct, students? It can also be equal to half into, now the direction is important here. It is AB crossed with AD. If you want to find in this direction, DB crossed with BA. I can also say it is equal to BD crossed with BA. This also is possible. Observe. Get the thing, students? It's the same thing. I'm sorry, students. Oh, shit. I cancelled it. Okay, students, so we will take a break and we will come back.